Want to double your channel views and your channel subscribers in less than a month? Stick around because today I'm going to show you how I use the tool Tubebuddy to explode my channel in 1 month. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Trena Little if you are new here and I'm a video content strategist. Just remember, if you aren't subscribed to this channel yet, just go ahead and click that subscribe button. And today I'm going to explain to you how I use Tubebuddy and give you a tutorial on exactly how you can download it and start using it today. At the beginning of this year, I was using a combination of YouTube search and Google Keyword Planner to really optimize my videos. And then I found out about Tubebuddy. And I used Tubebuddy to optimize all of my videos it was between the middle of January to the middle of February. And I wasn't being really super active on any social media platforms because I had just had a baby at the end of December. But I started using Tubebuddy to optimize all my videos by using their Tag Explorer and finding great keywords and keyword phrases to really utilize as a strategy in my videos. And I was able to double my views that month and get double subscribers. So I'm gonna jump on over to my computer, show you how you can download Tubebuddy today and start using it to grow your channel. So to get Tubebuddy for your YouTube channel, the first thing you obviously need to do is to create an account on Tubebuddy. So you can sign in over on Tubebuddy. I'll put a link down in the description box below. It will be an affiliate link, so if you click on that, it will help me out. But if not, just go to tubebuddy.com and sign in with Google because YouTube is associated with Google, so you'll need to sign in with Google. Once you sign into Tubebuddy, you will be taken to your dashboard. Now, as you can see here, I have multiple channels on this dashboard. And this channel right here, Tips with Trena, is a paid for account with Tubebuddy. And then this one right here, I have as a free account. So let me just go over a few of the things that you get with a paid account versus a free account. So with a paid account, you get this health report right here, and we'll go in and check it out. With the health account, you're just giving a lot of analytics to really help you strategize and figure out what's working on your channel and what's not working on your channel. You'll be given the amount of views that you have, subscribers, uploads. That's just the total videos that you've uploaded. It's also going to show you your performance, your subscribers up or down in the last 30 days. It's also going to show you your traffic sources, which is a great way to find out how people are finding your videos. So you can see my biggest search term right here is Snapchat analytics, and it's based on a video I did last year. You can also look at related videos that you're getting traffic from. So you can see what videos you're creating that's causing people to watch more of your videos. And then you can also check out websites. So you can see Pinterest is really my number one traffic source. Also my website, Google search is another high traffic source, which is amazing because that means I'm ranking my videos on the front page of YouTube search results probably. And the same goes with YouTube. That means that my videos are ranking in YouTube for specific phrases that people are looking and they're watching my videos. Gmail right here, I use my videos in my email newsletter. So I let people know when I upload a new video in my newsletter. So that's just showing me that people are actually going from my newsletter over to my YouTube channel to watch my videos. So this is everything you get with a paid version. You do not get that health report with the free version. You do get this launch pad, and with the launch pad, we can go in here and see what all it has. So it's going to show you your recently processed videos. You can create a checklist so that you can ensure you get everything done to optimize your video that you can. And then the paid version gives you even more options. It shows you how many opportunities you left on the plate. So if you go in here to opportunities, it's going to tell you the three things that you can do. It found three more opportunities to help you get this video ranked higher. It's also going to give me some suggested tags to help with my SEO and get my video ranked higher. So it's showing that these are my current tags down here. And these are some tags that maybe I should add to help my video rank higher. And you see, they break it all down here for you. You can also create a checklist for every single one of your videos. And this will show up beside your video every time you upload a new video. So you can see here, this is what my checklist currently looks like. And this is what I did with this video. I wrote a compelling title. I entered a complete description and I added descriptive tags, a thumbnail, and I added that video to playlist. What I did not do was add info to cards, engage with the video, promote across existing videos, share on social media, which I did do. I just didn't do it through the TubeBuddy platform, so it didn't recognize that I actually did it. And then you can check out best practices, and you can process this video for best practices. And it's just going to go through to make sure you did everything that you could possibly do to optimize your video. So the title is checked, the tag, the cards, the playlist, the caption, annotations. And here it's showing me that my title probably isn't the best it could be. And it's suggesting that I change the length of the title. It's a bit too long to be optimized and could be optimized better. It's also telling me that my description has a broken link. So what I actually didn't do here was add a space. So now I just easily went in there, added a space so that my link works, and hit save changes. And you can instantly correct these changes right in the TubeBuddy platform, and you don't have to go back into YouTube to the description and fix that. You could also go in there and change the title of your video if you wanted to right within TubeBuddy. Then it's going to tell me that my description, the broken link, was fixed. So now you want to add your Google Chrome plugin. So let's go back to TubeBuddy. And what you want to do is install free on Chrome. Make sure you are on your Chrome browser. You don't want to be on Safari or Internet Explorer. You want to be in Google Chrome to install this Google Chrome plugin. So go ahead and click the green button. This is going to pop up, and TubeBuddy is completely safe to download. It's actually authorized by YouTube, so it's not going to affect anything on your computer, no viruses, nothing like that. So go ahead and add to Chrome, add the extension, and now you'll see TubeBuddy has been added right up here to your Google Chrome. So let's go back to YouTube. If we refresh it, you want to make sure that you link your channel through the Chrome extension. So you'll just go in here and link your channel. Make sure you check your channel and then allow TubeBuddy to access it. And now here's what I'm talking about with the biggest tool within TubeBuddy that I use. The Tag Explorer right here under extension tools, this right here, Tag Explorer. So I'm going to go through and show you how I use Tag Explorer real quick. So we saw that I did a video on why create a YouTube channel for your business. I'm going to explore the Tag Explorer, and it's going to show me most used tags. It's also going to give me a keyword search score right here. So you'll see that the search volume is in the middle. It's between high and low. It's going to show you that the competition is getting pretty high. This red means high. So overall, it has a keyword score of a 42 out of 100, which means it's not competitive, but it's also not searched too often, making it an average keyword. What would be optimal is for you to find a keyword that had a high search volume, like landing right in here, and a low competition landing right down here. So you want to get these arrows into the green for a good keyword score. And anywhere from 50 and up is really a good keyword score. So if you have the free version, you're only going to get the first three options right here, which doesn't really help you much. So you just want to try to mess around in here to try to find a good keyword score. So I use why create a YouTube channel for your business. It's a 42 out of 100. So maybe I'll go down into here. Just look why you need to start a YouTube channel, and I'll click on that. And again, it's showing me this is an average search. It's got a 40 out of 100. So I just go through here and I start trying to find a keyword that's going to give me a good score. You can also go over here to auto suggested, and it's going to give you YouTube auto suggested tags and Google suggested tags. I'm working on creating a video on using quizzes to build your email list. So let me just try that keyword. So I use how to use a quiz to grow your email list. You'll see it has a good keyword score, but do realize that it has a very low search volume, so it's not going to get a lot of traffic, but you do have the chance to rank because it has a very low competition. So it's a good video to start ranking for and building that authority on YouTube. And then obviously you can click on something generic like this, how to grow your email list, and you can see how generic it is. It's very bad. It has very high competition. It has low search volume, but I can use this as an example for auto-suggested. You can see over here on YouTube, a suggested tag is how to grow your email list fast. And then here are some phrases from Google, how to grow your email list fast, how to grow your email list using Facebook with Instagram. So you can easily click on that. Go back to summary and see what that keyword score looks like. So that's a much better title for a video if you focus on how to grow your email list with Instagram as opposed to how to grow your email list, just a general video idea. And down here is all your recent searches, so you can go back and forth. But do remember, with the freed version, you only get the top three of these, so it helps you out a little bit, but these will also be very highly competitive tags. If you haven't started a channel yet for your business, make sure you grab my YouTube channel checklist right here. Just click that card. It'll also be in the description box below. It's going to show you everything that you need to do to really set up your channel to make sure you're targeting your ideal client. If you found this video helpful and you think somebody else might actually learn something from it, make sure you share it on all the social media platforms below, Twitter, Pinterest, Facebook. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoy tutorials from me. And thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I will see you next time. Bye.